Hello, my name is Aaron Fisher, and I am the Youth Livestock and Equine Specialist in the Department of Animal Science at the University of Tennessee. I am presenting a video study series focused on beef cattle related topics for Skillathon. This particular episode will focus on beef cattle breeds. We will talk about several popular beef breeds in the U.S. and how they are classified, where they are from, and the important qualities that each bring to the beef cattle industry. Beef cattle breeds can be classified in many different ways. The first is at the species level. Beef cattle in the U.S. are generally known as Bos taurus or Bos indicus. Bos taurus cattle encompass cattle found in the U.S. along with their European ancestors. These breeds are typically cattle that are from a temperate climate. A temperate climate is defined as a place with moderate rainfall, warm to hot summers, and cool to cold winters. This is indicative of most of the U.S., and thus Bos taurus cattle make up the majority of cattle in the U.S. Bos indicus cattle originate from India and are known for adaptability to hot, dry climates. We will talk about this more later, but the Brahman breed is the basis of Bos indicus cattle in the U.S. They are typically found in the hotter climates of the southern and southwestern United States. We will further classify Bos taurus cattle into British and continental cattle. British cattle originate from Great Britain and are primarily known as maternal breeds. This means that they are known for good maternal instincts and milking ability. You will commonly hear people use British and maternal interchangeably to refer to these breeds. Continental cattle are those breeds that originate from continental Europe. This refers to countries like France, Germany, and others. These breeds are known as terminal type breeds or breeds known for high growth, performance, muscle, and other carcass traits. Just like with British and maternal, you will commonly hear people use continental and terminal interchangeably to refer to these breeds. Bos indicus cattle are also known as zebu breeds. They are recognized by their hump above the shoulder and an abundance of loose skin. The loose skin increases the surface area and thus increases the animal's ability to rid its body of heat. This is a big part of their ability to remain productive in extreme heat conditions. As I mentioned earlier, when you talk about Bos indicus cattle in the U.S., you are really talking about the Brahman breed. They are the basis of the American breeds, or breeds that were developed in the U.S. We will now discuss several of the more common breeds seen in the U.S. When discussing the breeds, we will focus on color, horn status, size, and where they are from. One important term to clarify is polled. Polled refers to being naturally or genetically hornless. Polled cattle were born without horns. The first British and maternal breed is Angus. Angus are black and polled. They are known as a maternal breed with excellent growth and carcass traits. They were imported to the U.S. in 1873. Angus is the most popular breed in the U.S. The next British and maternal breed is Hereford and Polled Hereford. Some people will consider these two separate breeds. Hereford are from England and have a red body and a white face. Hereford are horned and Polled Hereford are obviously polled. Polled Herefords were developed from naturally occurring hornless Hereford cattle. They are a maternal breed that is known to be very hardy. Hereford were introduced to the U.S. in 1817. Red Angus is the next British and maternal breed. They are from Scotland and originated from naturally occurring Angus cattle that were born red. Red Angus are red and polled and are known as a maternal breed with good terminal performance. The last British and maternal breed is Shorthorn. Shorthorn are from England and can be red, white, or roan. Roan is a mixture of red and white hares. They can be polled or horned. They are known as a maternal breed and are very popular in the show ring and club calf industries. Shorthorn were introduced to the U.S. in 1783. Shifting to the continental and terminal breeds, we will start with Charolais. Charolais are from France, are solid white, and can be horned or polled. They are a terminal breed known for high growth and heavy muscle. Charolais were first brought to the U.S. in 1934. Next is Chianina. Chianina are a continental and terminal breed from Italy. They are white with black points and are known for size and growth, being the tallest breed of beef cattle. Not as common in commercial beef production, Chianina are very popular in crossbreeding programs within the club calf industry. Examples of this would be Key Angus and Key Maine cattle. Chianina were introduced to the U.S. via artificial insemination. Gelbvieh is a continental and terminal breed from Germany. They can be red or black and can be horned or polled. Originally selected as a dual-purpose breed known for meat and milk, they are now known for good growth and excellent maternal traits. Gelbvieh was imported to the U.S. in 1971 by importation of semen. Limousin is a continental and terminal breed from France. They can be red or black and also horned or polled. They are known for muscle, leanness, and producing high-yielding carcasses. Limousin cattle fit well in programs like the Lara's Lean Beef Program. They were imported to the U.S. in 1971. Maine-Anjou is another continental and terminal breed from France. Being originally red with white markings, they can now be red or black. They are known to be a very heavily muscled breed. Not as common in commercial beef production, they are very popular in crossbreeding programs within the club calf industry. Maine cattle were introduced to the U.S. via artificial insemination. The last continental and terminal breed is Simmental, which is from Switzerland. Originally with a red and white color pattern, they can now be red or black and can also be horned or polled. Simmental were originally selected as a dual-purpose breed for meat and milk. They are now known for excellent growth as well as being one of the heaviest milking terminal breeds. They were introduced in the U.S. in the late 1800s but did not last and were reintroduced in the late 1960s. As we talked about earlier, Brahman cattle are the predominant Bos indicus breed in the U.S. It is from India and can be light gray to red to almost black and do have horns. They are characterized by the large hump and lots of loose skin. Brahman are the basis for the American breeds and are known for heat tolerance and adaptability. Brangus is considered an American breed that is black and polled. It is basically a crossbreed consisting of 3/8 Brahman and 5/8 Angus. Brangus were developed to get the heat tolerance of Brahman and the maternal and carcass traits of Angus into a single breed. Its development began around 1912 in Louisiana. The final breed is Santa Gertrudis, an American breed that is red and horned. Another crossbreed, it consists of 3/8 Brahman and 5/8 Shorthorn. Santa Gertrudis were developed for the heat tolerance of Brahman and the maternal traits of Shorthorn. Developed at the King Ranch in Texas, Santa Gertrudis is known as the first official breed developed in the United States. That wraps up our discussion of beef cattle breeds. Please recognize that there are many more breeds that we did not discuss today. For more information and background on all beef cattle breeds, the Oklahoma State University Animal Science Department maintains the most comprehensive breed site for beef cattle as well as many other livestock species. You can also check out the individual breed association websites. I wish you the best of luck as you progress through your beef cattle project. If I can ever be of assistance, please let me know. Thank you and have a great day.